Hello students, in today's session we are going to discuss about an important component of the cell, and that important component, it plays a vital role or an important role in the functioning of the cell. Okay, so the component or the part which we are going to discuss today is nucleus. Okay, this nucleus, it is the main part of the cell, because this nucleus, it controls all the activities which are performed by the cell. So this topic we have taken from class 6th chapter 2, that is the cell. Okay, so it is in the ICSE 6th class chapter 2, the cell, and the topic is nucleus. So basically nucleus, this nucleus, it is the largest cell component, okay, which is present in the cell. So nucleus, it is present in animal cell as well as plant cell. Okay, in animal cell the nucleus, it is present at the center, but in case of plant cells, you all know that plant cells, they contain large size vacuole. Okay, plant cells, they contain large size vacuole, that's why the nucleus, it lies at periphery in the plant cell. Okay, in plant cell it lies at the periphery, thoda sa kya hota hai, side pe. Okay, so basically jo hamara nucleus hai, jo nucleus hai, kis cheez se bana hua hai, it is composed or it is made up of proteins, it is made up of DNA, and it is made up of RNA. Now this DNA is deoxyribonucleic acid, and RNA is ribonucleic acid. Okay, so basically this nucleus, it is composed of proteins, DNA and RNA. Okay, so these are the important materials of which this nucleus is made. Okay, now students, basically nucleus, its part are see, this is the structure of the nucleus. Okay, this outer membrane, this is nuclear membrane or nuclear envelope. Okay, on this nuclear membrane you can see here these round bodies are present, these are known as ribosomes, and these ribosomes, they helps in making of proteins. These ribosomes, they help in making of proteins. Okay, so the nucleus, this is the structure of nucleus. Okay, so there is a membrane outside this nucleus which is known as nuclear membrane or nuclear envelope. On the surface of this nuclear membrane or nuclear envelope, these round bodies are present which are known as ribosomes, and these ribosomes, they helps in the synthesis of protein. Okay, now this nucleus, it contains a fluid. Okay, it contains a fluid which is known as nucleoplasm. Nucleoplasm, like beta, see, the cell contains jelly like substance which is known as cytoplasm. In the same way, this nucleus, it contains a fluid, okay, which is known as nucleoplasm, and in this nucleoplasm lies the nucleolus. Nucleolus again this is a spherical body, this is nucleolus, okay, and here in this membrane you can find out some pores. These are the pores, okay, these are the pores on the membrane and these are known as nuclear pore. इनको हम क्या बोल देते हैं, न्यूक्लियर पोर. ओके, सो इनसाइड दिस न्यूक्लियस द स्फेरिकल बॉडी इज प्रेजेंट विच इज न्यूक्लियोलस एंड दिस न्यूक्लियस इट कंटेन्स अ लिक्विड पार्ट विच इज नोन एज न्यूक्लियोप्लाज्म. ओके, दिस न्यूक्लियोप्लाज्म इट कंटेन्स एंजाइम्स, इट कंटेन्स आयन्स, ऑल दीज आर प्रेजेंट इन दिस न्यूक्लियोप्लाज्म. ओके, न्यूक्लियोलस बेटा सी द नंबर ऑफ न्यूक्लियोलस, इट कैन बी वन और इट कैन बी मोर देन वन. नाउ दिस न्यूक्लियोप्लास्ट इट कंटेन्स दीज थ्रेड लाइक स्ट्रक्चर्स विच इज नोन एज क्रोमैटिन नेटवर्क. इसको क्या बोल देते हैं, क्रोमैटिन नेटवर्क. और यही क्रोमैटिन लेटर ऑन दीज क्रोमैटिन दे कंडेंस टूगेदर टू फॉर्म क्रोमोजोम. And you all know that okay. So now let us see this nucleolus, it can be one or more than one, and this nucleolus it contains RNA and proteins. Okay, this nucleus is containing RNA and proteins. This is the nucleus. For identification I have made it like this. So RNA, already I have told you, it is ribonucleic acid, and this chromatin network, okay, this chromatin network, it is made up of DNA and protein, that is deoxyribonucleic acid and proteins. Okay, now later on what happens, these chromatin network, these chromatin networks, the thread like structure which you are seeing inside this nucleus, this chromatin network it condenses to form chromosome, it condenses to form chromosome, and these chromosomes they carry the hereditary information from parents to offspring. Okay, and these chromosomes, these are responsible for carrying the genetic information during the process of cellular reproduction. Okay, so this is regarding the nucleus. Okay, it is a spherical body, it can be observed with the help of microscope, it plays an important role in functioning of the cell, it contains, okay, it controls all the activities which are performed by the cell. Okay, it is made up of proteins, it is made up of DNA, it is made up of RNA. RNA is ribonucleic acid, DNA is deoxyribonucleic acid. Okay, then this nucleus, it contains a fluid or a sap which is known as nucleoplasm, and in this nucleoplasm there is nucleolus, and the number of nucleolus it can be one or it can be more than one. Okay, then here these thread like structures, they are known as chromatin, okay, network, and these chromatins later on when they condense they form chromosomes, and these chromosomes they carry the hereditary information, okay, from one generation to another generation through the process of cellular reproduction. Okay, so this is regarding nucleus. Thank you.